Before I get into anything remotely significant, I would just like to say that I'm not a fan of my voice. I'm looking to have my vocal cords in place of a synthetic copy of Benedict Cumberbatch's beautiful throat strings. Anywho, this is Hydrogen, guaranteed to make you wet. Hydrogen, as most of you know, is element number one on their periodic table. This does grant her some privileges, like being one of the only elements people remember from high school. She also doesn't really have to watch her diet, since she metabolizes at the speed of light. Other kids could make fun of her, but at the end of the day, she can still blow you into oblivion. Hydrogen was discovered in 1766 by Henry Cavendish. The word itself is composed of two parts, hydro, meaning water, and genes, meaning generator, and together they mean water generator. Or maybe generator water. I don't know, do I look Greek to you? Hydrogen at room temperature is a flammable, odorless, colorless gas. So much like Jake Paul, she's full of hot air. It's also very light. So light, in fact, that the Zeppelin company thought it was a good idea to use it to fuel the Hindenburg. And we all know how that worked out. Even so, hydrogen still has a wide array of uses in our world today, such as in pollution-free fuel cells for vehicles, in the chemical industry as a key part of the Haber process which synthesizes ammonia for fertilizer and cyclohexane and methanol for plastics and medicines, the glass industry, the electronics industry, agriculture, business, education, anything that involves humans, you, me, the man down the street that begs you for money and you never give it to him because capitalism. Mr. Clean, right behind you. So as you can see, hydrogen is an essential part of our society. If one day she decided to leave, we'd all be screwed. So let's give her a round of applause. Alright, fun's over. When hydrogen is placed in a gas discharge tube, which is basically what all those neon signs you see in the city are, it glows either purple or pink, depending on how she's feeling that day. What happens in that tube, which I'll be mentioning a lot in the future, is that you have ground state hydrogen being assaulted by massive amounts of energy. And what do you do when you get assaulted? Pull out your Uzi and shoot the shit out of that guy. This produces light, and depending on the type of weapon you're using, the light can come in different colors. Personally, I like pink better. It brings out my feminine side. Now, whether or not you're in chemistry, we can all agree that hydrogen knows how to get laid. Literally every molecule seems like they have at least one hydrogen atom in them, unless it's a salt or diamond. Carbon doesn't like to admit this, but he gets harder when he plays with himself. But that'll be covered on his video. Right now, hydrogen is in that oxygen mood, and it takes a lot of energy to get her out of that mood. However, she generally gets well with everyone. Except the noble gases, those pompous sons of bitches. Hydrogen plays an important role in acid-base reactions, hence the term pH. These reactions involve an exchange of protons between the solvents. Hydrogen, essentially, is that proton. There are instances, however, where hydrogen isn't simply an electron trying to get it with a proton, even though they'll never touch in any universe. You see, when hydrogen is in a bad mood, her metabolism slows down and she starts getting depressed and gaining Jimmy neutrons. Jimmy neutrons are bad because they affect her internal chemistry, and that's when we get things like heavy water, and in some cases, radioactive water. And as someone that is very emotional, it's not that hard to do. In fact, 0.0156% of the water we drink contains heavy water. Of course, like the romanticization of mental disabilities that seems to run rampant on certain websites, some scientists claim that this empty shell of a happy hydrogen can, in fact, bring humans longevity. Whether you believe it or not is up to you.
So vanadium, you might be asking, how abundant is hydrogen in the universe?
Great question! Hydrogen is the single most abundant element in the heavens above.
So is our atmosphere mostly hydrogen then?
Haha! If that was true, we would have been dead a long time ago. You see, for being such a simple element, hydrogen is a mess. She doesn't have her priorities straight, her head is so far in the clouds that she literally went past the upper boundaries of her planet. Hydrogen only exists in small quantities relative to other elements in the atmosphere as water. Pure hydrogen gas, in that regard, is close to non-existent. So the next time you hear someone say, "Gee, I don't know why we haven't converted to hydrogen fuel cells by now," you can just pull out that gas from the sky. Feel free to hand them a dunce hat. Where hydrogen is abundant, though, is in stars. Where hydrogen is built into helium at... And we can tell a star's chemical composition by looking at its emission spectrum. If the star has a bright red line around here, it means that there's quite a bit of hydrogen in there, and the star should be looking at a couple more million years of stardom. Now, for the most anticipated segment, is hydrogen lethal? Yes. Did you know that 100% of humans who ingest hydrogen at some point in their life die? But seriously, don't mess around with pure hydrogen gas. And that pretty much sums it up. The next element you'd assume I'll be doing in this series is helium, but unlike OH-, I'm not your basic bitch. Feel free to suggest the next element in the comments below. Also, I know I just said I wasn't no OH-, but please, like and subscribe to Vanadium Valor if you want to see more stuff like this. There will also be links to my DeviantArt and Tumblr below, where I post the rest of my element personifications. So if you want to get ahead of the game, go check them out. This was purely experimental, but it was quick, easy, and fun. I appreciate the support. Until next time, selamat malam, nerds!